into a state of flow, an outflow of divine love, and the rising sense that we are, not to use a cliche, but that we are one with everything, that everything we see is an aspect of our own self. So in the third stage, our small self, our personal self, becomes expanded to become universal divine self, where we recognize that everything that we see is an expression of our own self. So those are really the milestones we used. And,
yes.
And like I said, they're not goals. Well, they are in terms of helping motivate us to practice. That's really why I put them in the system, so that people would be motivated to practice.
Yes.
They're not there so that you can, like, have an extra stripe on your sleeve that says, well, now I'm ecstatic, or now I'm in unity,
mm-hmm.
or now I'm enlightened. I don't think enlightenment can really state itself. I think when anybody states that they are enlightened, I think that that is actually a statement of the opposite.
Hmm.
And that's one of the ironies of spiritual development, that enlightenment never proclaims itself. Because how can inner silence proclaim anything? It doesn't proclaim anything. It just flows.
Yes.
As soon as we're proclaiming, it's the mind. The mind is doing that. And the mind, you know, is the servant of inner silence. So it can't proclaim anything either if it truly is illuminated. So it's a bit of a, you know, bit of a paradox there.
Yes.
Enlightenment is a paradox.
Well, we're almost out of time, Yogani, but I'd like to ask you, do you think that there's great benefits in groups and retreats? Because I know you've written about that in this book, too, about having group gatherings.
I do. And coming from the Internet, we've been at a bit of a disadvantage on that. We have the global group meditations. We have, you know, face-to-face meditation groups popping up all over the world, where people are just leading them in their homes and so forth. We have some initial movement going on toward teacher training, and there have been some AYP retreats, not many, but there have been a few. So yes, I would encourage people who are involved with the practices to get together, and there's plenty of support for that in the support forums up on the website. I should also mention that in the book that we're talking about, there is a chart, somewhat of the notorious AYIP chart that has all the practices on it with a grid that shows how they fit together and how to put them together over time. So it's more or less self-explanatory, but I did want to mention that there
and
is
very useful, I'm sure.
A chart with everything on it.
Yes. So once we've walked this path and have accomplished much of what you're talking about, would you say it's then our duty to pass on these teachings to others?
Yeah. That's what I'm doing, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, I've spent nearly 40 years on the path now, and about 6 or 7 years ago, I realized that if I didn't pass on what I'd learned, that a lot of it would be lost. So I think when people find value in their practice, they should pass it on. The advantage of AYP is you can do that horizontally, person to person. There's no vertical hierarchy that has to be satisfied. There's no strict requirements that have to be met. It's just a matter of letting people know, you know, hey, there's some tools here, and if you want to do something about your spiritual path, take a look, you know.
Yes.
So, yeah, you know, I strongly believe in the principle of paying it forward.
Yes.
If you've seen that movie.
Yes.
You know, if somebody does something good for you, then you should pass that on to others.
Absolutely. Yes. Wow, that's fantastic. Yogani, we're out of time, and we are at the completion of the whole series.
I'm so grateful to you, Dr. Ann, for making this possible. It's a wonderful thing, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you so much. I've enjoyed it tremendously. And, of course, you know, I've been using myself as a guinea pig throughout this whole year and have been going through my own ups and downs and self-pacing with it. And I look forward to continuing with all of these teachings and for my own practice and continuing to deepen my practice and my understanding of self and my divine marriage.
Well, as we say, the guru is in you and it's in your hands.
Yes, it is.
AYP is just a toolbox that hopefully can be helpful.
And maybe you should give out the AYP website again.
Yes, it's AYPsite.org. AYPsite.org. And everything can be found there.
Everything you need.
Everything. Everything except your desire to do something, and that you have to bring to the table.
Absolutely. Yogani, thank you so much.
I want to wish you and everybody a happy new year and wonderful holidays. And may 2010 be a breakout year for everyone.
Yes, I hold that vision. And the same back to you and your family and everybody listening to this. A happy new year. And namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you, Yogani.
Well, that's it for the series on enlightenment that's been going on Truth from the Source with me, your host, Dr. Anne West, for a year now with Yogani from the AYPsite.org. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I hope it's been enlightening for you.